Directed by Chris Columbus, the 1999 film Bicentennial Man tells the story about a robot created by a corporation and sold to a family as a household appliance. As you may have guessed, it doesn't stop there. After all, what kind of a science fiction film would? Although this film explores robotics and artificial intelligence, much like others do, it does it in a way that leaves few questions unanswered. There are no what-ifs to contend with as the film ends and wraps things up rather elegantly. Some might even say that it takes the easy way out, providing a bittersweet ending. During one of the beginning scenes, the robot, played by Robin Williams, which will now be referred to as Andrew, is shown plugging himself in, producing some kind of look on his face like he just had an epiphany, and then falling into what looks to be some kind of dream state. At this point, I believe the singularity has occurred that so many people fear. The point that artificial intelligence is able to learn and improve upon itself, as stated by Keith Roderschreimer, software engineer of the Singularity Institute for Artificial Intelligence. There are many films that portray artificial intelligence in this way, but few of them show an AI as nice as what Andrew becomes. A little later in the film, Andrew is handed a glass figurine of a horse that he thinks is beautiful, only to drop it, making the little girl of the family who owns him upset. It is apparent that he wants to make up for what has happened as he attempts to learn how to create things out of wood, eventually creating a replacement figurine for her. Andrew's learning does not stop there, however, and many years later wishes to obtain his freedom from the family that owns him. After many years of reading books and gaining an understanding of humanity, Andrew wants to progress his movement into humanity. He is ultimately granted freedom, but at the cost of being exiled from his house and family that has owned him. Throughout the next 40 years or so of Andrew's life, he thinks that he is free, able to take on a more human form, take an expedition to find others like him, and to ultimately fall in love with a human. Andrew's freedom is soon realized to be an illusion when he is barred from marrying the woman he has fallen in love with because he is not considered human. While not technically a slave, Andrew is enslaved by technology, as alluded to by Jeffrey Shaw in Illusions of Freedom, Thomas Merton and Waqas Ilal on Technology and the Human Condition, the same technology that provided him with his initial existence. Andrew vows to overcome his inability to be recognized as human and makes the decision to die after it is ruled that his positronic brain is immortal. He takes a transfusion of blood that will ultimately degrade his robotic parts and cause him to die like a human. Andrew dies just seconds before the World Senate declares him to be the longest living human on record. Many humans in history have died for what they believe in, freedom being one idea out of many. I think that Bicentennial Man is the only example of an artificial intelligence that is willing to embrace the human condition to the point of death, just to complete its goal of becoming human.